there were trams in Edinburgh for 85 years. Work on the line started in the late 1860s. The first passengers were carried in 1871. The heyday of the old Edinburgh tram network was the interwar period. They ran from Fairmile Head to Granton and Leith, from Corstorphine right out to Port Seton in East Lothian. The very first horse-drawn tram ran from Haymarket through the city centre and along Leith Walk to Burnett Street, the same route which the new tram line will follow. Some of the staff who worked on the old network have fond memories of it.
Now it's double shifted in the 23 trams. That was Polcarra Street to Grand Road Station. Changed there and went back up and down all the time.
To me, it was a better atmosphere. And the driver and conductor, they worked together, and it was a lovely situation. You know, you got along there, you enjoyed it, and you enjoyed the passengers.
I ended up going into Shrub Hill. I went into the stores for a short period, and when I was 16, I started my apprenticeship in the body shop at Shrub Hill, and it was working in tram cars and buses. But I did actually spend quite a lot of time helping the men on the tram car.
It was an easier job than driving a bus, no doubt, two doubts about it. I mean, we were outside Saltcross Depot, and when the street fitters, we were tormenting them, saying, at the time they were off the road, they're finished. He said, I'll tell you something, chum, you wish you were back on, and he was right.
We used to get parcels to deliver all over the town. And I always used to remember, we used to get a tram car at Waterloo Place, I think it was number 21, going to Leaven Hall. And we used to go to a monastery there at Leaven Hall. We used to take parcels of the yeast for the monks. And you're always sure of getting after you've got away up the big hill, after you've walked away up, you're always sure of getting a sixpence tip.
Work on the new network took a long time in the planning. It was over 10 years before the first ground could be broken, and the Scottish Parliament had to give its approval to the project.
There was a white paper produced in 1998 about Scotland's transport. TIE itself was set up in 2002 and started working on the tram project. Because we run through the city and we run through land that didn't belong to the council, etc., we had to go to Parliament to seek approval to build the tram system.
This is a civil engineering project of considerable complexity. Wherever the tram lines run through the streets, utilities like gas and water mains, electricity and power cables have to be moved. Roads need to be closed off and new traffic management systems put in place.
A great deal of planning went into working out how traffic is going to be accommodated through not only the tram works, but as you can see now, we're busy completing the utilities works in this area. As part of the tram scheme, we have commissioned a traffic model which covers the whole city, but the tram route in particular in some detail, and that's been used to test not only this particular area but also other areas in the city, including Princes Street, York Place, the West End junction with Lothian Road, which is another very complicated junction, which enables us to test not only isolated areas but also combinations of works that are happening together, so we can work out how best to deal with the traffic.
All of this planning helped make sure that the city didn't grind to a halt when major works were undertaken. But work was sometimes brought to a halt by unexpected discoveries. Edinburgh has a very long history. Interesting archaeology is always close to the surface. They found a Neolithic settlement near the airport. There were wartime bomb shelters at Haymarket, and these bodies under Constitution Street in Leith.
So far we've found 200 bodies, and we'd expect to find possibly up to 300 in total at the end of the excavations. Some of the bodies are buried in shrouds and others in simple pine coffins, some of them again have been buried individually or as part of group burials. The bones will be taken back to our offices and cleaned and stored there. At a later date they'll be examined by our specialists who will try and get an idea of the age and general health of the people and look at the bones for evidence of injuries or diseases.
It's a fantastic opportunity to look right through the centre of a city. You know, you don't normally get this level of archaeological intervention and the chance to just see the whole development of Leith, the development of Edinburgh, development of the new town. It's all there in these deposits, in these trenches, so you get the full picture, or it helps fill in the gaps in some of the known archaeology and history as well.
For much of 2009, most of Princes Street was closed. It allowed work to be completed faster than closing the street in stages. By June, people were able to see progress when the first rails were laid.
It's an excellent day for the Edinburgh Tram project and for the city of Edinburgh, not just Tyne. I think it's a very constructive day as we see the start of the laying of the tram tracks in Princes Street. The construction of the tramway is in various stages, as you'll probably see in the shot behind me. You'll see overhead line bases being installed, and then the actual tangible effect that the general public will start to see is the concrete bases for the track form and the starting of laying sleepers, which will seat the tram rails. That's what people will see when the finished road level is completed at this section.
From then on, everyone put in considerable effort to make sure the work was finished before the Christmas rush. After 9 months, Princes Street reopened, just 3 hours late.
There's been an enormous effort by our contractors and subcontractors, particularly over the past couple of weeks where the weather has been absolutely atrocious, had the wettest month of November ever, and our contractors and all these guys out here worked through that 24/7, just sheer determination to get this finished on time.
I was along looking at Princes Street a couple of weeks ago, and even then it still looked a very, very optimistic hope that everything would be ready for reopening at the end of November. But there has been a huge amount of effort put in. I gather there's something like 150 to 200 people working at the moment, all working really hard to ensure that Princes Street is open once more to business, to traffic, to residents and visitors. I think this is an incredibly important milestone. As the work has become more visible to people walking past on Princes Street, I've sensed a change in the mood. Previously, there was a bit of disgruntlement, of people claiming they didn't know what it was all about. Now, as you go along, I believe that people are taking ownership of the tram. I overhear people telling their friends what it's all about, and the tram's going to the airport, it's going to be down at New Haven Ocean Terminal. And I sense a real change in the public perception now that they can actually see the visible signs of track down on Princes Street.
Sadly, little work has been carried out in the centre of Edinburgh since the start of the year. But it has continued out to the west of the city, at Gogar, where the control centre will be based, at Edinburgh Park, where this huge viaduct has been built, and on the other side of town, at Leith Docks, where this new bridge has been installed. In northern Spain, the trams are rolling off the production line at the Basque company CAF. Some of them started undergoing tests in Germany in the spring, before being sent across to Scotland. The first tram arrived in Edinburgh in April 2010, the first in a fleet of 27, which will come to run along the city's streets.
The city of Edinburgh, now this tram is the most modern tram that you have is in Europe. Clearly, it's the longest in UK, but it's the most modern in Europe. And really, we are designing a product for the next 30 years.
Edinburgh Trams still intend to complete the line as originally proposed.
The route of the tram effectively goes from down here, which is New Haven, down by the shore on the Firth of Forth, and comes into the city centre, runs along Princes Street, and then goes right out to the airport.
It's now a question of finding an effective way in which the obstacles can be overcome and the vision can be delivered.